Hello everybody, welcome to a new Legacy video. Today I'm playing The Epic Storm, a deck that takes the name from the fact that it wins the game by storming off with Tendril of Agony, loses 2 life, gain 2 life, and storm. This deck is slightly different than Ad Nauseam Tendril since it doesn't play Discord spell and it doesn't have Passing Flames but relies on Burning Wish to go get your important cyber cards like Tendrils, like Echo Beyonds now. This is one of the main ways to just go off with Lanza Diamond. But there's a new card, Galvanic Relay. Pretty cool card from Modern Horizons 2. There's another new card here from that set, which is a Progenitor Ooze. Kind of skeptical on this, but this could be a nice B or slash C plan against the slowest decks that might have, like, you know, it's just basically an additional Empty the Warrens, the card A Progenitor Ooze. The deck is trying to get a combo together with Wishclaw Talisman and Burning Wish. Wishclaw Talisman is an artifact, so that can tutor up, that can turn up your Metacrafter Mox Opal together with Lanza Diamond, Lotus Petal, Crow Mox, and there's some defensive card in the deck like Defense Great Anvil of Summer. Kind of weird to see this already in the main, but that's Legacy. Legacy is a format where Counterspell is very powerful, and if a deck doesn't have Counterspell, well, that means that you're probably favorite already. Surely you can just draw a lot of these and be worse than you would normally be, but you still can cyber them out for Chain of Vapor, Abrupt Decay, maybe a couple of Galvanic Relays. So yeah, that's the deck. Let's head down to a league with The Epic Storm. Remembering that this video is sponsored by channelfireball.com, which sells Magic the Gathering card boxes, but also there's a lot of articles there to write, to read, not to write. I am the one that's writing them with my Legacy Power Rankings that you can see every month, and also some Modern and Standard historic content, as well as Ultimate Guard, which is the other sponsor of the team, and they have great product to protect your cards like Katana Sleeves, deck boxes, Sidewinder, or archives to keep your cubes or your collection. Round one, I'm on the play with The Epic Storm. I love these decks because you always have to figure out what your hand is actually doing, and well, this hand is a good one. We have Echo Beyonds, as well as Mox Opal, which will be our land of choice here. I'm going to go Mox Opal, Lotus Petal, Lanza Diamond, Cast Ponder. Hope to pick up like a Veil of Summer so that I can just crack Lanza Diamond, the two of them actually, and get an Echo Beyonds with just drawing 7 cards with 3 mana in the pool. That is the dream. If the dream isn't happening, I'm probably just going off regardless, because, you know, that's the deck I'm playing today. It's the Storm deck. The deck doesn't play any Discord spell. The Ad Nauseam Tendrils deck does. Alright, put a mulligan to 5. It's not ideal to give your opponent a hand of 7 new cards after the mulligan, but on the other hand, I can't really do much. And of course, I might also go off without doing the ponder, because that would give me 1 extra mana, but I think just finding a Veil of Summer is pretty big. So let's go Mox Opal, Lotus Petal, Lion's Eye Diamond, I don't need a second one. Alright, let's cast Ponder here. Okay, that's a lot. Couple of lands, and now I don't think I need the lands here since I'm just gonna get 7 new cards if this works, and if that works, I'm just thinking, maybe I can, like, keep that as a B plan. Let's say I cast the second Lion's Eye Diamond, then I play Echo Beyonds. I don't crack the second one, I only crack the first one. And I get like 2 mana to go off, and I still have Lion's Eye Diamond in play. And like, if they have a force, next turn I'm just drawing the Wishclaw Talisman and going at it again with another Echo Beyonds. That doesn't seem like a bad plan in my opinion, so I'm actually going for that here. I'm just keeping the ponder around just in case my opponent has a force. So I'm just only cracking one here and casting this. I'll keep this in the graveyard. And again, if they counter this, I have a Wishclaw Talisman on top, which I can cast with these 2 mana here. Okay. All right. Am I regretting the choice? Not really. Actually, I haven't opened the display card preview, which I've been doing in the past videos here. Just in case. Just in case you don't know which cards. Well, I guess the storm count is kind of needed in this deck. All right, now my opponent got a new grip of seven, and I do have Veil of Summer and Defense Grid to protect myself. It's important that we take a look at our sideboard here, since, well, there's Tendrils of Agony over there, and I am certainly lethal here. I can go Lion's Eye Diamond, Veil of Summer. Not really, unfortunately. Yeah, wish I had some money in my pool now. Because if I want to go Burning Wish, I can't go Veil of Summer as well. Or I can just go at it again with another Echo of Yawns here. So I can do something like. Interesting situations I find myself in. I can just cast a Burn. Because the thing is that if I cast Burning Wish, I can't crack the Lion's Eye Diamond. If I'm cracking the Lion's Eye Diamond and they counter it, I'm left with nothing. So, once again, this is like I have to decide whether I put it as a counter spell or not. And I might just take a safer route here. Just cast Lion's Eye Diamond, cast Defense Grid, and pass the turn. Yeah, I'll cast Defense Grid here. I'll lose the petal though, but I have another Lion's Eye Diamond to keep the Metalcraft up. And if the counter does, that's fine. I steal a Veil of Summer next turn. Okay, and now I'm passing the turn since I can't do anything about this now. So again, I could have taken a more aggressive line and sacrificed both Lion's Eye Diamond, of course. I probably won the game this turn. But even if they have a. All right, let's see what they do now. Entomb. All right. This is kind of funny. Oh, wait, they got Archon of Cruelty. Weird. All right, I was thinking I just die now after I give them a new card. But it didn't happen, so. Alright, now, I lost all my storm count too, which is definitely something. I have Defense Grid, so I don't need to cast Veil of Summer anymore. Alright, let's check Burning Wish again. Is this the time where we got Peer Through the Abyss? Yes. I have 7 mana now with 2 Lands of Diamond and a land drop. And once I draw, let's repeat, target player draws. Yeah, this must be a win here. So I'm just going to. Crack Pollute Delta. Does it really matter? Then I'm getting mana from this too. Because I'm cracking these things here. I'm holding priority. I'm holding priority. And I'm cracking this for black and this for black. Now this resolves, yes. And I'll go get Peer Through the Abyss, which I'll cast to target myself. Now, drew my whole deck, sorry, half of my deck. And it's 100% a win here because this deck has just way too many free cards for this not to be a win. That's 9. Yeah, and I can just cast the tendrils. Alright. This was a good game. I decided to play safe and ended up not going off on turn 1, even if opponent didn't have a counter. But I think overall, I mean, it was a good game. To show off the. To start off the stream, definitely. Now, I have to decide whether I want to sideboard anything against a reanimator deck. Well, I don't think so. Maybe Veil of Summer doesn't do anything on the play. Put in as a discharge spell that will cast it on turn 1. I can just have like Chain of Vapor, this bounces. the Icon of Cruelty. I'll put it in Tombs for that and not for Grizzle Brand, so I don't know. Do I want Abrupt Decay? Yeah, I really don't think that Veil of Summer is playable in this matchup, in the sense that if opponent has a Disc Dispel, they cast it on turn 1, then I can't cast Veil of Summer. So, I think this is fine, let's go with this. Second game against Reanimator. Go ahead and keep this hand. It's not very powerful, but... I don't know, should I mulligan these hands? Probably, maybe. Maybe, actually. The thing is that I don't have any interaction from my opponent. So if they go, you know, just like Grizzlebrand turn 1, I am dying to it. So I'm just keeping a hand that is... And also my opponent probably is playing a lot of Distress spell, so... I don't really want to mulligan that much. My opponent, by the way, here mulligan to 3. You can see it in the log here. Mulligans to 3 cards, and well, they better be good. Well, actually, I hope not, they're not too good. Can they do something on turn 1? Not really. I guess just discarding a card is what I can do. Alright, they go in Tomb. I mean, if they kept landing to reanimate, I am not doing much. Okay, so it is time to put a Grizzlebrand in the graveyard and not the Archon of Cruelty. I draw. Sorry, but I don't know what to put this. I mean, I guess I can close it. Alright, here seems fine. I'm just trying to figure out where is the best place. Alright, I drew a Nauseam, not great. I'll go just Tropical Island. Pass. No, was I supposed to play Brainstorm? I mean, maybe. Right? Maybe this is the kind of deck that goes turn 1 Brainstorm. Sure, I will actually. I'll just draw lines at my deck of Yawns here. Well, let's say the opponent has one card in the hand, but they have Grizzlebrand in the graveyard. Alright, this is pretty terrible, but that's okay. I'll hide a Chain of Vapor since I like that. What's the other card I want to hide? Problem of Sopal? Since I'm going to shuffle that one. Alright, and they pass the turn. Good to know, good to know. Draw Chain of Vapor. Now... I kind of want to keep up Chain of Vapor now, because when I reanimate Grizzlebrand with a flat, with haste, like a Shallow Grave, I want to bounce it. But then they just already just refill their hand, I'm going to discard everything, so I think I die. So let's see if I can do something different here. Oh, Wishful Talisman is also an artifact, I failed to mention that for my Mox Opal to be turned on. Okay, now I can go Burning Wish, Rite of Flame, and I have one blue-green mana up. That's not great. That is not great. On top of that, there's a Mox Opal. Remember that legendary, so you can't tap two together. Well, I can just go Witchclaw Talisman go here. I think that is fine. Just setting up for the next turn. Got a Badlands. And I hope they pass the turn again, I guess. Not casting the Mox Opal because of Storm Count. Now, Wishclaw Talisman will give me any card next turn. Alright, they drew a land, so they are able to go, what? Animate Dead. Alright, so they have Grizzlebrand. Let's see if they have Unmask in their deck. Maybe Grief. There's also that they can have. Maybe Lotus Petal, of course. Funny enough, if I kept up Chain of Vapor, I could have bounced this Anime Dead, and my opponent wouldn't have been able to reanimate. Okay, so the discard Chain of Vapor. Pitching? What did I pitch? Reanimate. Okay. They have 2 mana and 11 cards. They play Grief. Pitching Unmarked Grave. Unmarked Grave is the Entomb for a non-legendary. Way worse than Entomb, but Sorcery, it costs 1 more, and it says non-legendary. Alright, it grieves my Burning Wish, okay. Is the wish called Talisman in play? Let's see how many times the random grief. Yeah, I mean, playing Mulligan 2-3 ends winning this game, which is kind of funny. But then again, I didn't want a Mulligan because my opponent plays so many Discord spells, so I just kept a hand of, you know, 7 cards. That was a pretty consistent turn 3 kill. Alright, they have 3 cards. They have 3 life. I mean, 3 life? 3 life is not that much. I have 10 Drills of Agony in my deck. Yeah, this is easily a win here. It's going Lotus Petal, Mox Opal. It is funny, but it is over. I'll go Rite of Flame. I'll tutor up Tendrils of Agony. Now I'll kill my opponent. Good game. Alright. Razor Brand drawing cards and Tendrils just dealing 8 is good enough here. I hope at least. They might have Mindbreak Trap. Alright, Nyori Grande wins the match as we back for round number 2. Round 2 with the Epic Storm. Once again, I have to figure out what is this end doing. Well, it doesn't cast on Nauseam on turn 1, but it's on track to do so on turn 2. I think this is a keep. There's also a desperate play of, I'm not in that shape, but... Wait, I guess I can. I can just go Ponder and correct Land's Eye Diamond. No, I'm not gonna do that. But, you know, I just empty my hand on turn 1 if I want to. Alright, put him all against the 6. And I just go get a blue land here. Well, I guess I could have used the Mox Opal now that I think about it. Maybe that would have been better. Anyway, let's get Underground Sea and play Ponder. I should have put a Wastelands here, it's not a big deal. Alright, well, so this is the 5th land I need to cast a Nauseam, but I prefer just shuffle in here. And I found a Brainstorm, which I get... Actually, let's just go Petal, because I can go Petal, Opal, Lion's Eye Diamond, and have Brainstorm up. I guess that is fine. I'm losing some Storm count, but I don't think that really matters here. Now I have Opal up in case my opponent goes up for Thoughtseize or, you know, anything like that. It looks to be another unfair deck. I pitched Cabal Therapy. Ooh, Summoner's Pact. Wow. Yeah, this is definitely something unfair going up here. They got Elvish Spirit Guide, Turn Timber Symbiosis, and they play Balustrade Spy. Well, that usually ends things. I can go Brainstorm, but I can't really find anything, so that is it. I lose. We did not have 5 mana on turn 1, unfortunately, for the Ad Nauseam, so here we go. They milled their deck, and I died. Alright. I'm getting some pretty fast matchups here. I don't know if you know their combo, but they mill 3 Narcomoebas, then they go Dread Return, and Reanimating Thassa Oracle pretty easy. Okay, oops, the old spells. That's why my opponent's up. I'm keeping the Veil of Summer now, because I'm on the play, and they've shown me Thoughtseize. Yeah, once again, Galvanic Relay isn't for this matchup, so let's just submit the deck. Game 2. I guess I have a little regret of not having cast that Brainstorm in my turn, because I could have, you know, just found like a good card and like go off. I guess I was just keeping it to pitch to my Chrome Mox, but it's maybe not the best play. Okay, we got a new hand here, and I'm kind of like, there isn't a free way to deal with graveyards like Fear Macabre, Surgical, I don't know. Yeah, I guess sorcery speed wouldn't be good either way. So yeah, I guess there is not. So looking at our sideboard, I am not finding anything that's worth picking up for turn one. So here I'm keeping this hand because, and I'm going just turn one Rishkla Talisman pitching Brainstorm. The reason being that if my opponent wants to go off on turn one, fine, I'll lose. If they don't, they have like a discard spell or something like that, I will be able to win on turn two, or at least I hope to win on turn two. So I'm gonna pitch Brainstorm so I can get like Badlands here. Go Chromox, pitch Brainstorm, and then I'll cast the Talisman and pass the turn. And let's see if they just kept a reactive hand with Thoughtseize or a combo hand with Dark Ritual. I don't see the Informer. Let's see if they have a mana to activate it. Please don't. Alright, Sinnoh Spirit Guide. And here we go. Yeah, they combo twice on turn one. It's what it is. It's what it is. I was hoping that would keep a hand with like Thoughtseize and like stuff like that. Maybe a Leyline of Sanctity, but it's not that. Opponent did the thing twice. They milled their graveyard. Narcomoebas goes into play. Yeah, there's like Dread Return. Dread Return will reanimate Tassa's Oracle, and I will lose the game. And that is fine. And that is fine. My opponent is a turn one combo deck. We are a turn two combo deck. So yeah, turn one wins. All right, let's be back for round number three. These games have been fast. Round number three on the draw. Once again, we have a turn one Wishclaw Talisman. This time there's the Echo of Eons, but there isn't a Land's Eye Diamond. Let's see how this hand will evolve here. Opponent kept six. Oh, Ancient Tomb. Okay. They pass. Alright. Yeah, defense grade doesn't seem good in this matchup. I'm going to cast this Wishclaw Talisman here. And do I want to also cast Mox Opal? Sure. There was no window for me to activate Mox Opal because I have to sacrifice this or cast this. Our opponent goes Thran Dynamo and Thrinosphere. This is annoying. This is very annoying. So I have to look for a third land before doing anything. I guess Wishclaw Talisman can find me something, but nah, that's not it. Remember now, every spell costs three. Okay, Reality Smasher. Attacking me for five. Yeah, I have to pass here. When I get the third mana, my opponent has a lot of mana there. I got a 10, so I have two more turns here. But if I use this, they'll get a Smasher and kill me, so yeah, I probably don't have any more turn. They get like the Cascading Cataracts now to activate Golos next turn. Actually, I don't think I have any more outs here. Yeah. Unfortunately, I can't cast my cards. Alright, good game. Thrinosphere, historically the bane of any combo deck's existence, especially one that's called Storm, which you're supposed to cast multiple spells in the same turn. Yeah, Veil of Summer not really performing well these leagues. I'm just sideboarding easily, I think. Everything else seems to belong to the sideboard. I don't think a Progenitor Ruse is good. Oh wait, there's Defense Grid here, I'm sorry. Alright, let's bring in Galvanic Relay and Aviar. Yeah, this looks solid. Let's go for a game number two against Pod? Sorry, Pod. 12 posts. Game 2 against 12 posts. Alright, here's a Appreciator who's not looking great in this hand. Which I'll be keeping since I can go turn 1 Ponder, looking for some mana, and then maybe we can win on turn 2. Scarson is very hard to cast. Alright, let's go. Tropical Island Ponder here. Okay, I do find lands. So, these are not fast mana though. What can Burning Wish get me that's like easy value? I mean, Empty the Warrens. I can go Burning Wish for Empty the Warrens. And then the turn after, I can go Brainstorm, Dark Ritual, Empty the Warrens. That's 6 tokens. I think I'm shuffling these. And I'll pass the turn. There seems to be a bit lag, but that's okay. Ancient Tomb, let's see if this is a chalice. It's a green monolith. Is that turn 1 training sphere? Could be like a Mindful Key to untap the monolith and that 4 mana. Thought not seer. Strong. Strong but not devastating. I'm definitely still in the game. Did I shuffle my deck? I just wanna just make sure. With Ponder, I mean. It did shuffle, yes. Alright, so they got Dark Ritual, understandable. Abrupt Decay. Alright, it's not bad. How about I go Abrupt Decay on this Grim Monolith when they try to untap it? Yeah, you know what? This is actually my line here. I'm not really looking to Burning Wish for anything currently. The Zuba. And yeah, I think that's what's happening. They're trying to untap that and I'll kill it. And what happens is, sure, I could have also killed the Manifold Key. That would have been okay too. But this way, I make them spend a mana and they might also just have multiple. Actually, they probably don't have multiple keys or they would have played them. Wait, they just drew it, one, because of course they would have played it last turn if they had it. Alright, I guess my play paid off. Anyway, Ad nauseam. Right, I don't have anything to do with just casting this Burning Wish. What do we go get here? Well, there's Empty the Warrens, but honestly, every option sucks here. I really don't know. Oh wait, there's something exiled. What is it? It's Dark Ritual. Oh no, that's not how it works. Never mind. I mean, I could get a Empty the Warrens. The problem is that all these Burning Wishes are like. Yeah, I need mana. I even drew Ad nauseam here. So I just have like mono threats. I'm missing mana. Difficult choices. Like if this was a wish, the 3 mana wish, I could have also got like Lands of Diamond. The new card. I mean, of course, that costs 3. I don't know. I guess I have 3 mana this turn. Anyway, we can go get Echo of Eons and just hope to top deck. But I guess if I top deck, I can just do that again next turn. You know what, I'm just getting Galvanic Relay. It's a pretty terrible play, but at least like if I draw 1 Ritual, maybe we can go off. And I don't think I have that many other like good choices. Mine's super clunky, Ave is pretty terrible. Hopefully I don't have a disruption piece. I can get behind a Thought Not Seer, honestly. Man wasn't amazing, but it had a Dark Ritual. With a Dark Ritual, I would have been able to cast Ad nauseam this turn and most likely have won the game. I All right, let's see. 4 mana, Thren Dynamo. So they have lots of mana here. A lot of mana here. Okay. Yeah, the Abrupt Decay just didn't do actually much. So that's 5 mana. It costs Karn, which is terrible since it stops all my artifacts. And I have a lot of artifacts in this deck. Let's see what's the one drop that cast here. Alright, I got Torment's Grip, but this deck doesn't really suffer graveyard hate. So I should be fine. Of course at one turn and next turn I die. Not cracking the land. Just drawing. What do I draw? Chain of Vapor. Does this do anything? I mean, I can redraw bouncing the Thought Knot Seer. Or I could let him get a lattice, cast the lattice, and then I just Chain of Vapor the Karn, I guess, and the lattice doesn't do anything. So I'm just buying a turn. How much mana do they have? They really have a lot of mana, but they only have one card. Karn can also attack me for 4, so that'll be 8 damage. I think it's fine though, like I really don't have another play. So I'm just going Burning Wish for Tendrils of Agony. Point and taps to Ancient Tomb, they go to 8. And it also Pulverize. Pulverize lets me play around the thing pretty easily. It's not a bad idea. I can get Pulverize instead of Tendrils. I'm doing that actually. And I'll pass. I could also just Chain of Vapor the Thought Knot Seer to just redraw and add the storm count. I don't know what. Now they can just go like Trinisphere and also stop me that way. But like, how do I deal with that Trinisphere? Just try and go off this turn by bouncing the Thought Knot Seer, I guess. Okay, so they didn't plus Karn, meaning that they went a minus. And I go to 8. And let's see what they want to do with the Karn here. This is one of the strengths of this deck. It doesn't suffer graveyard hate. I mean, I guess that you do have Echo of Eons, but it's not in my hand currently. Yeah, Polarize should play around. I think you may sacrifice 2 mountains rather than pay it. Yeah. Because, for example, Force of Vigor doesn't work because you have to pitch a green card to kill the lattice, but. Alright, so the minus 2 to Karn. Let's see what I get. Please let not be a Trinisphere. I'm just dead to Trinisphere. There's no way I can beat it. What's that? Walking Ballista. Okay, they got a Walking Ballista. Interesting. How much mana do they have? Okay. So they're trying to untap the Thren Dynamo. Let me count how much mana do they have. They have 2, 4, 6. They untap this. 9, minus 1, 8, plus 3, 11. So the Ballista's for 6. But I'm not dead, right? Maybe they just have a land here. I'll let them do this, like I can just. So they go to 4, 7, 11. So they have 11. Even if they play a land that's 2 mana, that's 13. That's just 6 mana. Set to be 1 to each. Yeah, they have 11 mana. That's fine to me. They have a Walking Ballista, but that's not lethal. Yeah. So that's for 5. Sure. And now I have 1 turn to win the game. So I'm just gonna go Chain of Vapor end of turn on this Thought Knot Seer. Yeah, I have to take Underground Sea. Chain of Vapor on the Stunless here, draw a card, and then I just hope that I'll draw good enough to win. Basically, the two cards that I got with Burning Wish probably are not relevant. Okay, I drew Chromebox, that's good. Well, I guess it's not because that's Karn. Well, what do we do now? What is that I can do? I don't know. I guess I start with a brainstorm. Remember that Karn stops my zeros. And I can't even activate Wishful Talisman. Yeah, this is over. Alright, good game. Would have bounced the Karn, I guess. It would have opened me for more top deck. Cause can't use the artifact land. Alright, 1-2, let's move for round number 4. We are in round 4 against Wiki, which is a Nintendo player known to play Miracles. So I'm assuming they are in the new control, either Just Care band. Well, this hand is Veil of Summer, which is definitely good against that. I can also just go off on turn 1 with Rite of Flame, Burning Wish, and blah blah blah. But that's a little bit too extreme in my opinion. I am still keeping this hand, and maybe I can just go end of turn Brainstorm. End of turn Brainstorm, I think it's fine with this deck. Could have also gone main phase Brainstorm for the classic like Lotus Petal, Mox Opal draw, but I think end of turn Brainstorm is fine here. There's no actually I couldn't get Volcanic Island with this one. Alright, then I'm just getting Underground Sea. I'll go end of turn Brainstorm, hoping to get a land. I did hit it. What is that I am hiding? Doesn't really matter, I'm just putting these two cards that I can't play. And I'll be casting a Wish Claw Talisman here. And I'm passing. Next time I'll redraw the Veil of Summer. And I'll cast a Ponder. I'm tapping this land to cast this Ponder. Okay, that's a bad land. And that's another Veil of Summer. Remember that you can't use the mana from Lands of Heaven to cast Veil of Summer. Okay, so now I could... I kind of want to go Burning Witch for Echo Beyonds here. Because if that resolves... No, actually. Just can't cast this Veil of Summer, it's kind of annoying. If I go Burning Wish, I can get Galvanic Relay. Yeah, I mean, I guess I'm doing that. I'm shuffling those. I mean, not really, because I need the land. Alright. I'll do this. Shuffle already, no. And then I'll just play Burning Wish. They counter this, I'm okay with that. And I'm getting Galvanic Relay here. I can also get empty warrants, but my opponent can easily have a Terminus in their deck. Yeah, I prefer getting this than the Echo of Eons. If I had green mana, I would have got the Echo, of course, but the fact that I don't have it makes me just not want to go for that. Next turn, I can just cast my spells. This is why, with this deck, I think you want to hold off your Lands of Diamond and then such. Okay, it's this an Arset. It's a Back to Basics. Well, that's annoying. And now I can't do basically anything. They play what, Jace? Okay. Top of the deck is another card that I can cast. And now I have to hope there's a land, I guess. Even a Mox Opal would be fine with this hand. Yeah, back to basics. Ooh, counterbalance. With chasing my sculptor around. I am conceding the game. I want to see what's the last card they're casting there. Teferi, Time Raveler. Okay. Alright, back to basics. Did win the game. I'm gonna maybe use the Wishclaw Tasman to do something, but I just was... I don't know. I felt like I wasn't under that big of a pressure, but I actually was. Alright, let's bring in this. Let's bring in... How many Aurelius do I want to bring in? Like this, probably. And can cut Tendrils. Can cut Echovions. Can maybe also cut this Wishclaw Talismans. Yeah. I think I'm doing this. I choose to switch Galvanic Relays for Talisman. Do I want to maybe cut some of the fast mana cards? Not really, because I need them for the relays. I decided to cut the talismans. It's also weak to just, you know, artifact removals and Teferi. Yeah, I preferred this. I do want to keep a Galvanic Relay in my cyber. I think this is very good to pick up with your Burning Wish. Let's go with this. Round 4, game 2 against blue-white control. I can't keep this hand. I will keep this one. What's on my bottom in here? It might be just a Lion's Eye Diamond. Yeah, it'll be. Lion's Eye Diamond is really good with Burning Wish. How about an Abrupt Decay? Not really, let's just bottom the Lion's Eye Diamond. Alright, I'm just picking up Underground Sea or Tropical Island. What do I want to take here? I'll get the Tropical Island. Okay. Okay, these cards are very good. Although it's missing a land. I mean, Chromox it kinda is, because I can pitch the Abrupt Decay to it. I just hoarded a bunch of these and just... Nah, I think I'm keeping this. I don't want to mulligan. I don't want to shuffle this. And I have to keep all my spells, because I have Galvanic Relay around. So next turn, what I can do is actually just cast Ponder. Look for a land, and then I'll be able to go Chromox Petal, land Galvanic Relay. So I will go for Ponder here. Actually, I can't do that because I need to get both the relay and the land. Okay, then I am just picking up the land, making the land drop. I want to play a petal. Am I afraid of a counterbalance? Not really. I really think that obviously I'm afraid of the counterbalance, but I do have Abrupt Decay, and I really think that the storm count is just so important for the relay there. Okay, let's see if they cast the counterbalance. Null Rod. Okay, that's fine. Draw. Unfortunately, I can't cast the relay this turn yet again, because I need to Abrupt Decay and Lord first. So I guess I'm passing again, holding on these spells to go off in the same turn. It looks like they pass without making a land drop here, and I'll go Abrupt Decay on this Lord Rod end of turn. Pretty epic tutor for the drop instead of the yes. All right now. I'm casting Chromox, pitching probably Galvanic Relay here. Yeah, why not hold Burning Wish to my hand? And I'll cast this for 3. I guess I could cast Veil of Summer first. No. Because even if, remember, this works for next turn as well. This is not just Rotary. This is not Act of Impulse. So I exile 3 cards. And I can use them next turn. No, I can't. Oh, during your next turn. I'll pass here. I guess I've been reading this card wrong. I really thought it was like Mind's Desire. Okay. Anyway, still strong, of course. This is the matchup where you want to draw it. And now we're going off, are we? So let's begin with a Ponder, I'm guessing. This is just more mana. I don't think I need this. I'll play land. And what am I burning wishing for here? I don't know, but I'm certainly playing Rite of Flame, because again, it's expiring. Surgical on Galvanic Relay. Okay, I don't think Little Summer works there, so that works. Thankfully, I held Burning Wish and pitched to Galvanic Relay. So they only exile two, because one was already exiled on the Chromox, and one it's in the sideboard. Actually considering picking it up now, the fourth one. So I cast Burning Wish, and then, yeah, I think I'll go for another Relay. Opponent doesn't seem like they are. I mean, I can also go for Empty the Warrens. It's not a bad idea. Do I have the mana? Yeah, no, because I already made a land drop. Alright, let's cast Burning Wish. They do have a Little Summer in hand. I mean, I guess I am casting this. Should have maybe led with a Veil of Summer. But yeah, it's pretty obvious that they have a counter. That's okay. So the three cards and I lost the counter war. That's fine. I could have kept the Brainstorm among the cards. I went to shuffle since there was Brainstorm and two rituals. Maybe I could have just kept the Brainstorm since I had a Polluted Delta there. Living Legal Click. This is not Custer Mage. Okay. Want the Burning Wish. Okay. So there goes Snapcaster Surgical and the Burning Wish. Very interesting. Now I don't have basically. I have like very few ways to win. Because the. I have boarded out Tendrils of Agony. So I only have Abe. And I boarded out the Talisman, the Wishclaw Talisman. I have like one Nauseam and one Abe here. Definitely lacking experience in the matchup. Even the sideboard maybe wasn't on point. Maybe I should have just trimmed the Chromox and the Opal. I was scared that then, like, I guess this is matchup. This isn't really a matchup where you have to be afraid of your of missing your mana. Okay. So I have a tag in my deck for sure, and the pedal is the third green. So that is my plan now. I just draw that Abe. Put a nose about it too. Okay, Brainstorm is a good draw. Let's cast it. Yeah, pretty bad to go by those Summer here, but I mean, I need to resolve my Brainstorm. I guess it's still a 1-for-1. You're always used to your Veil of Summer to be a 3-for-1, a 2-for-1. Now it's just only countering the Power Blast. Looks like they have another Power Blast. Okay, then I can't do anything about this. Stepcaster mage keeps on attacking. And they have two cards. I'll hold this Verdant Catacomb. Since looking to drop Brainstorm. Yep, same thing. Still not giving up, since if I draw an Ave, I could, something might happen. Not sure exactly why, what, but that could be like the C plan, since most of the plans are gone here. No more Burning Wish, no more Galvanic Relay. Do I want to go for Abrupt Decay on this? Or do I want to keep it for the Storm Count? I think I have to go Abrupt Decay since I don't have that much green. I barely have enough green to cast. Alright, so there it is. That's my Brainstorm. Need this to resolve desperately. If it doesn't resolve, I don't know. Have to wait one more turn. Okay, looks like it does not resolve. Sure. Yeah, win the important counter war, and then even one simple Snapcaster might win the game. Okay, I have one last turn. When it attacks me down to 3, I'm gonna crack 2 fetch lands. Go down 1, and then okay, let's get the Taiga. Where's the Bayou? Do I have a Bayou in my deck? I do not. But yeah, Lotus Petal will be fine. Okay, let's draw Maeve. Nauseam. Alright, that's not good. GG. 1-3. Let's be back for round number 5 with the Epic Storm. Final round with a mana heavy hand. I think I'm mulliganing. Okay, I'm keeping this one. Returning the mismatching Chromox. And this hand is scary. Isn't it scary? Let's see if my opponent is playing counter magic or not. Marsh Flats. Okay. Savannah. You love to see a Savannah. Alright. Here we go. Savannah Birds of Paradise. That's the cards I wanted to see. Those were the cards I wanted to see. Alright. So, how much money do I have? Let's count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So I can cast Burning Wish. And I'm not gonna get any Galvanic Relay because I know that you can't cast the cards now. It's not Mind's Desire. I can't cast Pierce Through the Abyss. I guess I'm going actually for Galvanic Relay. Trying to think since I have, let me count again, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and that's just one short. Actually, 7. I have 7. 7 mana I have. Burning Wish doesn't do it. I just have to get a Galvanic Relay here, I think. So yeah, let's go. Badlands, Lotus Petal, Mox Opal, Chromox, Pitching, Dark Ritual. I guess I can also not pitch to exile an extra card. That's better. Yeah, that's better. I'm gonna say no. Then I get... Yeah, that's enough. All right. I'll get Dark Ritual. Dark Ritual. I'll play Burning Wish. I can get 14 tokens here. I can get 14 tokens here. But I don't think that's, like, good enough. Or, like, good at all, actually. Just getting a Blink Relay. Cast it, pass the turn. That's solid, I think. Okay, so I flipped a bunch of cards. Two Wishclaw Talisman, a Lotus Petal, Tendrils of Agony, Burning Wish, a Veil of Summer. Not the best, but that's okay. I wonder if you should just be playing Galvanic Relay in the main deck. I don't know, I guess there's spots where a Burning Wish wins the game. And Galvanic Relay is just the lazy of one. Alright, let's see if they go like Grinsen Zenith for Gaddock Teague. That wouldn't be a good sight. Collector, oof. Huh. Not good either. Could have gone Empty the Warrens. I was afraid. Yeah, I think I lost again. Wishclaw Talisman can't be activated because of Collector Oof. This game just cost one card and that's Tendrils. Alright, good game. Next time I'm going for Empty Warrens. Just a solid good old plan and without trying new cards like Galvanic Relay. I wanted to just try new cards. I guess it didn't work. Alright, now let's bring in Decay, let's bring in Chain, and a couple of Relays. I'm taking out the Veil of Summers and Grits. Let's go. Second game. Okay, what does this hand tries to do? Well, I can't go Burning Wish turn 1 with Echo of Eons. So I'm just simply... Or maybe I can. Let me think about it. Because I can go Dark Ritual Wishclaw Talisman, tutor up something. But, and I can tutor up that Echo of Eons. So I can actually get a reshuffle. I guess it's a reshuffle of opponent starts with Wishclaw Talisman. Now, that's not the best place to be. Let's just go land go here. And next turn I can do something. I'm gonna pick up a red land. And next turn I can get Echo of Eons with one black mana in my pool. That's better. Oh, a Thoughtseize. Okay. I can choose between Burning Wish and Wish. I mean, I guess every choice is okay here. Every choice is fine. And I just untap, no need to fetch. Like, if they take Wishclaw Talisman, I mean, Wishclaw Talisman is basically a 3 mana Burning Wish. Gotta go Lensei Diamond. Interesting. Very interesting. I'm fetching up that red land now. Just got a Taiga. And I just do this, setting up for the following turn, where I can get the Lensei Diamond with the Wishclaw Talisman, and the Echo of Eons with the Burning Wish. But yeah, I don't realize how much this deck suffers, like Null Rod, Collector Oof, and Karn the Great Creator type of effects. But you have so many artifacts, either in the mana section, but also in this Wishclaw Talisman is actually, you know, an artifact. I've been making lots of these, like, colored one. Okay, they go Noble Arc, and they pass. Mox Opal. Alright, let's go Dark Ritual. Let's activate the Talisman. And now, yes, I can spin the wheel, which is pretty strong. Yeah, I think it's just pretty strong overall. I can also get the another ritual, so that'll put me up to 4, 5, 6. So it's still not enough for the Pure Throat Depths. Is it not? If I get Dark Ritual here... Wait, actually, maybe Lance Diamond gets me there. Alright, Lance Diamond is just best. So, let's cast this. No, that's not enough. That's fine. Alright, let's cast a Burning Wish. And I'll get the Echo of the Onseer. And I'll flash it back without passing priority. Draw fresh 7. Hopefully. Mind Brick Trap. Endurance. Okay. Yeah, it's very important that you just, yeah, the Scarlet Zaman cast us immediately. Okay, so they evoked Endurance, which... Very, oh, I guess they exiled the card. Alright, they exiled Dryad Armor from their deck. Sure. Okay, what now? Well, I can go Dark Ritual, that's 3 mana, 4, 5, 6. Yeah, I think this is it. I'll go Petal. I'll go Dark Ritual. I'll go Rite of Flame. And I guess I can just go Burning Wish first. Yeah, whatever. I'll go Burning Wish, that's 2 mana, sure. I'll go Catendrils. Then I'll go Rite of Flame. And then I go Tendrils, you. Okay. I think that's good enough. Alright. So we go to the final game of this league against Abs and Maverick with this curse spell. Now, do I want to bring back the Veil of Summers? I guess since I'm on the draw, I don't want to. I'll stick to the Abrupt Decay and Chain of Vapors and Relays. Yeah, let's go with this. Last game, and is good. We have Abrupt Decay to deal with Annoying Permanence, Fast Mana, Payoffs, Cantrip. We got it all. Okay, they go Marsh Floods, go Mulligan to 6. Nauseam, okay. I'll play this land here. Since I thought it might have a Wasteland. Let's see. Bayou, okay. Collector, oof. Okay. Now, I have to get a black land with that Pollute Delta. That probably bad land, so I can't cast this Brainstorm now. I will play around Veil of Summer, I think, by playing this Abrupt Decay my turn. I don't think it's very important to kill that oof. So I just go Badlands, Abrupt Decay. And I'll pass, still holding this for the couple of relays that I have in my deck to add the storm count. Scavenging Ooze, alright, that's not doing much. And the Thoughts is me, okay. But my hand is loaded. This hand suffers the stones, the hate bears, you know? Doesn't really suffer a hand disruption. Of course, like taking Burning Wish is good. Alright, Dark Ritual. Well, that's... Yeah. It's 3. No, actually, Mox Opal isn't turned on yet. Let's cast a brainstorm. Because I have three. That's not enough. Let's cast a brainstorm. Alright, I'll put on top two zeros. Since they're free with the Nauseam here. Yeah, so I'll go Ritual, Ritual, and Nauseam. So while this deck is called the Epic Storm, Nauseam still one of the strongest card in this decks in general. All right, so I'll keep revealing. Those were for free. Yeah, I knew that. Let's keep on going here. You can see the cards here. Alright, that's a Wishclaw Talisman. Now, it's probably good enough to win. So, Tendril's in the deck. Do you wish to repeat this? No, I'd stop, thanks. So, let's go Petal. Lion's Eye Diamond. Lion's Eye Diamond. Throw Mox, sorry, Mox Opal. Now let's cast some red rituals since I have those. Let's cast Rite of Flame. Rite of Flame. I'll play a new Mox Opal here. And I'll play a Wishclaw Talisman. Then I'm also just playing a Chrome Mox because why not? Fetching a black land. And now I can crack those lands I diamond. I mean, I guess I'm casting a Galvanic Relay, why not? There is actually funny. But there is a problem. If I cast Galvanic Relay and exile the... Alright, let's just assume opponent doesn't have anything, right? If they had a Mindbreak Trap, they would have countered the Nauseam. Because why am I hesitating now? Because if I correct the diamonds to get the mana to cast this... I guess they don't need to correct the diamonds. Yeah, just get Tendrils. Never mind. I thought I needed to... The mana from the diamonds. Alright, so I get Tendrils. And I'll cast it on my opponent. Alright, so looks like we went 2-3. That's fine. The only game I have some regrets was maybe that game 2 against Miracles. Everything else went... kinda how it was supposed to go. If opponent goes 3 and sphere on turn 2, there's nothing you can do. If your opponent, you know, kills you on turn 1, both games, nothing you can do. That back to basics game 1, I also think I couldn't have avoided. Maybe that game 2 could have been played better. But yeah, overall, this is the league. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Please share some love for the Relevant Relays, now that we also know what exactly it does. And thank you guys for watching. I'll be back next week with more Legacy videos, and remember to press like and subscribe to the channel. Goodbye.